There are monsters lurking in the heart of every galaxy, known as supermassive black holes. They are capable of tearing apart entire stars and spitting them out as raw energy. When galaxies merge, these monsters collide, releasing more energy than 100 billion hydrogen bombs and shaking the very fabric of space itself by producing ripples called gravitational waves. Now, suppose there were a pair of colliding supermassive black holes right behind me. Yikes. My height would suddenly appear to get taller and shorter and taller, while my width would appear to get narrower and wider and narrower as the space that I stand in is stretched and squeezed by gravitational waves. Whoa, this may seem weird, but it is a prediction of Einstein's theory of relativity. In reality, these waves are extremely faint and are undetectable within the space of this room, but they are detectable at the distances to the stars by observing and timing pulsars. Pulsars are what remain of massive stars that exploded long ago, leaving behind a small rotating core. They emit beams of radio waves that regularly sweep across our field of view like a lighthouse. By precisely timing the arrival of their beams down to the nanosecond and looking for when their arrival times deviate ever so slightly because of the warping of space, we can detect gravitational waves. There's a global group of scientists and engineers known as the International Pulsar Timing Array currently embarked on this experiment, and they are faced with a problem posed by ionized gas clouds inhabiting the space between the stars that act like speed bumps that delay the pulsar signal by several microseconds as it travels towards us. I'm researching a way to remove this delay, a way to peer through the cosmic haze in the search for gravitational waves, by using one of the most sensitive radio telescopes in the southern hemisphere, called the Meerkat, to observe a remarkably bright nearby pulsar named J0437-4715. I know it's not the most romantic name. And by using algorithms such as the 2D Fourier transform, I'm able to detect these ionized gas clouds by the way they delay the pulsar signal depending on its polarization state. You can think of polarization state as simply the unique shape and orientation of the radio waves. Now, this delay depending on wave shape is known as birefringence, and it's the same effect that your LCD TV at home uses to adjust its brightness by rotating polarized light. By measuring, modeling, and removing this interstellar birefringent delay, we can improve the precision of pulsar timing arrays that may one day detect gravitational waves created by colliding supermassive black holes in the distant universe. What's all of this worth, you may wonder? What can it give us beyond even more mysteries to inspire the creation of new technology, art, and science? Well, not even Einstein knew the answer to that. Thank you. Now, suppose there were a pair of colliding supermassive black holes right behind me. I'm keeping that one.